Hey everyone, welcome to Denver Senpai channel.
Yo, I'm Sabina.
My name is Alex.
And today we're watching 22nd episode of the second season of Vinland Saga.
Olmer, as the successor of the master and successor of his will, decided to surrender, which was the decision that Thorgil did not like.
And Thorfinn still wants to talk to Kanate, and right now he joined 100 Pint Challenge to have this opportunity.
That's a great name for that.
And I want to remind you that we have a Patreon channel, so if you're interested in early access, full uncut reactions, please join us there.
Link in the description. Let's get it started.
Yay! Oh my god, that was a bad idea. That's insane.
Yeah, but it seems like Thorfinn knows which part of his face can be punched. Mm-hmm. Some people already lost.
Oh, yeah.
なるほど。
あの使者、確かに殴られ慣れているな。 拳が当たる直前に首や腰をひねって。
So yeah, he just catching the right moment.
それもごくわずかに。かわしていると気づかれぬ程度に。だがドロットも豪の者だ。この調子で長くは持ちまい。
Yeah, even like that.
Oh my god. Yeah, I feel Aina right now.
Oh yeah, he just lost Arnate and now he feels he can lose Thorfinn.
これが、そうなのか。 最初の手段ってやつなのか? それがお前の… お前の… これからの生き方なのか?
Hmm. Snake got there with Olmer.
おい、ちょっと…
トルフィン!
やめろ、おい! そいつは、農場とは無関係だ!
Yeah, dude, it's not about the farm. I mean, it is, but it's not real.
He got distracted.
Oh no. That was a bad one.
Yeah.
That's heartbreaking.
なんなんだ? やつらの石棺に100発耐えたら。 王様に直談判させてもらえる。バカな。農場のために。もういい。やめろ。話し合いで解決するくらいなら、とっくにやってる。本当に、そうか。本当に、真剣に。
Yeah, he's right.
But how can he can do 68?
Damn.
Well, I guess a lot of people already think he deserved to speak with the king.
Yeah, for sure.
Aenir believes in Thorfinn.
Yeah, nobody laughing anymore. He's already exhausted.
He's exhausted of punching him. How much left? 98,
oh.
3.
Oh my god.
But how Thorfinn is still standing.
That's crazy.
Oh.
Even that guy is impressed.
Yeah, everybody in shock.
ドールスナカ、ドルフィン、疑ってすまなかった。お前は本物の戦士だ。重傷殿、どうかこのトルフィンのお目通りをお許しください。
Well, guys, it's kind of impossible.
Not happening.
小兵だが、よく鍛えてあるようだな、トルフィン。だが、なぜ殴り返さないのだ。ドロットを倒せば、元この枝というお前の実力の証明になるだろうに。
なんだその質問は。和平交渉の相手をぶん殴ってりゃ世話ねえぜ。あんた方とは。今日会ったばかりだ。何の恨みもねえ。なんで俺たちが殴り合わなきゃいけねえんだ。バカバカしい。親玉二人でネファタフルでもやって白黒つけりゃいいだろうが、こんな大勢集まって血を流す必要は全くねえ。
True. Just let Kanote deal with Ketil.
あんた方は俺の敵じゃない。
What a speech, what a spirit.
The spirit of a broken man who is not broken anymore.
ケティルと王陛下がネファタフルか。
何がおかしい。
いや、すまん。そなた、王陛下に直接
Even he wants him to speak with Kanota now.
道を開けろ。
Okay.
シャドルを陛下の御元へお通しする。
He will force Kanota to speak to him.
来いよ、エイナル。戦争を起こす張本人に会うんだ。お前も言いたいことがあるだろう。
おお、あるさ、山ほどな。
見るな、エイナル。
パテールさん、
あの中にパテールさんを見つけてしまったら冷静でいられなくなる。
Yeah, Butter was the best. He held them so much.
Mm-hmm. Ooh.
That close.
Yeah, the last time Kanata saw him, he was a different person, so...
Completely. And same Thorfinn when he last time saw Kanata.
True.
Wakatta. Ao, sonata tachi no kimochi o sonchou suru.
Arigatou gozaimasu.シャ殿、こちらへ。
Surprised they let Einar go with him. Long time no see, Princess Kanota.
Yeah, they both changed a lot.
生きていたか。久しいな、トルフィン。そなたを奴隷の身に落としたこと、いや、アシェラッドのこと。
Not anymore. He worked this out.
お顔の傷、申し訳ありませんでした。
陛下のお顔に傷をつけた男。
The other reveal.
カルセブにかつてトルケル閣下と五分の戦いをしたという男。
Oh.
あんなに小柄で若いとは。
Impressive.
いやいば。
He wasn't king.
四年。もうあれから4年になるのだな。人を変えるには十分な年月だ。
クヌート、農場から手を引いてくれ。
できんな。
On which terms?
事の発端はケティル側にある。ケティルの子オルマルが重視になれぬのを恨み、
Oh yes.
10名を殺害したのだ。
だがもう十分だろう。農場側は100人以上死んでいる。
Yeah, that's your point.
さればこそ、ケティル一族の処分が済むまで戦は終わらぬ。
それはつまり、この農場を手に入れるまでってことだろう。王様なんて言っても、実際ただの強盗じゃないか。その辺の
場。But Thorfinn lets him speak, so he wanted Einar to say that.
Yes, yeah.
畑が欲しければ、
自分で作って
みようね。 She knows him, he knows he has temper.
死を耕して、見守って、育ててみろよ。そうすりゃ、それを奪うのがどれだけ悪いことか身に染みてわかるだろうぜ。
What are you gonna say, Kanata?
クヌート、お前は昔、ゲインズバラで言ったような、この地上にラクドを作る、生き苦しむ者たちのための理想郷を。
Yeah, if you kill everyone who suffer, nobody suffers.
いかにも、世はバイキングの親玉中の親玉だ。世こそは帝王、北海最強のバイキングである。千の船、万の兵を率いる将なり。世の力は人知を超え、
Scary, man.
不可能を可能にする。
But it's so irrelevant for Thorsen.
見よ。
And for Einar.
世の力であの波を沈めてみせよ
う。 Oh yeah, give it a try. Looked in the team like he's mad man.
帝王クヌートの名において
Oh my god.
波を沈め。
He's doing it.
That's so dumb.
Well, guess try next time.
Yeah, Kanata, you're so cool.
見たか、そなたたち、我が力を。
Yeah.
寄せるさざ波さえ止めることができぬ。
Oh, that was the point.
あの波を
起こ
しているものが誰か知っているか。
He tricked us.
So same as warriors and stuff. It's not his responsibility.
神だ。
Mm.
この地上に楽土を築くということは、奴の定めた条理に逆らうということ。神への反逆だ。我らを見よトルフィー。我らバイキングを。この混乱と破壊の担い手を。神に捨てられたこの者たちを救わねば、ラクド建設など到底かなわぬ。この者たちを制し、御し、その力を束ね、ラクドへ向かわせることができる者は、世を置いて他にはおらぬ。力が必要だ。人間の力を束ね、神と。
And to take farm.
It still sounds irrelevant for Thorfinn, I think.
Yeah.
But he thinks he's incredible.
俺は思いつきもしなかった。バイキングを救うなんて。
バイキングは力になるから生かして、役に立たない人間からは殺して奪うのか。ラクド建設が聞いて呆れるぜ。俺はエセルレッド王に村を焼かれ、スベン王に家族を殺された。もう真っ平だ。これ以上お前らの犠牲になってたまるかよ。
Yeah, Einar is incredible as well.
恨むなら恨め、そなたに許されようとは思わぬ。
だっとこの
よ
せ、エイナル。クヌート、改めて聞く、農場から手を引く気はないんだな。
ない。ケテルの富は世の事業に必要だ。
Pretty straightforward.
さすればどうする、トルフィー。今ここで世を殺すか。殺さぬ限り世を止めることはできぬぞ。
トルフィー、are you gonna surrender or not? In your own way.
As I thought, this conversation didn't really make any huge difference, honestly.
Well, it showed us how strong-willed both they are, mm-hmm. especially Thorfinn, with eventually accepting these 100 punches and getting to where he wanted, using his own way without violence. In order to get something, you have to give something. And he basically gave his body, being punched 100 times, and he gained a lot of respect from others.
Yeah.I understand that part. I'm curious what Thorfinn's actions going to be now. What's next? Leif already left. What he's gonna do? Like right now, what? All people of the farm, is it property of Kanata as well?
I guess if you will serve the king, you can stay there and work, or you will be killed.
Nice terms and conditions.
But he's building his own paradise in his own way, and he's not going to change it just because Thorfinn has something else to say. Because for him, Thorfinn is someone who probably cannot respect as well with his views.
Mm-hmm.
But he kind of already has his mindset. So yeah. He's going to do what he believes is right. Same as Thorfinn. The farm not being taken will be a scenario where either of them is going against himself. So it's either Thorfinn choosing violence and going to attempt to kill Kanota, which he can. Or Kanota will just go against his own ideals and his own view of the current situation and just retreating.
Yeah, I'm pretty sure nobody will change their mind. Actually, what I really like from this conversation that Kanota is actually pretty straightforward. He's not trying to lie and make it sound better. He's just like, yeah, well, that's my plan. That's what I'm doing. That's how it works.
And then Einar has the question, okay, what about people who are not your people?
Well, don't care about them.
That's already your problem not to be my people.
Yeah.
He's not saying that he wants to become a new god, but it's basically the war against God. So does Kanota see himself as the revolutionist, someone who is Antichrist?
Yes, he does. I think this episode was called Something Rebellious. So I guess that's what Kanota think about himself. And also we can see Thorfinn is rebellious as well. So yeah, a lot of metaphoric sense.
Mm-hmm. Both of them don't want the world to be at the same place as it was. But Kanota for some group of people, Thorfinn for everyone. And Thorfinn even accepted the idea that he himself never even thought about what's going to happen with Vikings. And that's what Kanota is thinking about Vikings. So for them, the precious idea of freedom, peace is similar, but from different perspective, from different sides.
Yeah, true.
Thank you for watching this episode with us. Like this video if you like it, subscribe to our channel if you'd like to see our future reactions.
Leave a comment below what you think about this episode, this conversation, and what's going to be next, but no spoilers. And see you in the next one.
See ya.